The cheating problem in Battlefield 5 is seemingly getting worse. It's definitely not going away, that's for sure. As if the game didn't have enough issues that it needed to sort out already, Battlefield 5 is now becoming one of the more popular destinations for cheaters. But not only for them to come and ruin a couple of matches and then get banned, but for them to stick around, to stay longer, and continue ruining other people's fun and experiences. There's no doubt that having cheaters in matches is really hurting the overall image of the game, and when cheaters aren't properly dealt with via a robust anti-cheat system, it makes the game an even easier target. Word then spreads amongst the community that like to cheat in video games, for whatever reason that might be, and the issue just becomes worse and worse. That's what's happening with Battlefield 5 at the moment. The footage in the background today has been provided to me by Travis. He's a South Korean Battlefield community member, and I'll link his original video down at the top of the description. The clips all come from the spectator mode in Battlefield 5, and well, it's very easy to spot the cheating here. You can see wall hacks, aimbotting, and even more happening in the footage, but the most alarming thing for me is that all of these clips have been collected from the last 4 or 5 days of Battlefield 5. 8 minutes of clips of cheaters just running riot in servers, seemingly completely unopposed by an active anti-cheat system. And it's ruining the game for all the people who have to play in the servers that the cheaters go into. According to Travis, there's been a huge influx recently of cheaters in China, and players in the Asian region are now suffering even more, that almost every single server they go into, there's a cheater in it. It's not simple to try and get away from them by quitting matchmaking again and finding a clean server. There's now so many cheaters that almost every server has one in it, and in many servers there are multiple cheaters all operating at the same time. Looking at this footage, personally, I now feel really lucky that I live in a region where cheating in video games is looked upon in a really bad light, but in more eastern regions, and particularly the Asian region, there are many players that don't really feel that this is morally wrong. It does appear that many players in these regions, however, do feel that this isn't right, and that something needs to be done to solve it, and that's why Travis made his video and provided me with this footage. Considering DICE does have an anti-cheat team that's dedicated to Battlefield 5 and the other games that they make and support, it only makes sense that the rules and regulations against cheating in their games should be enforced stringently. But right now it doesn't appear that they're being properly enforced at all, or something with the system that's been built isn't working to detect the cheaters quickly enough and deal with them in a timely fashion. We've spoken about the cheating problem Battlefield 5 had at launch, and still now, 9 months later, here we are again, still discussing it. And we're still no closer to having a Battlefield game where cheaters are caught, permanently banned for their actions, and dealt with in a timely manner. Cheaters can still run around cheating in games for weeks on end before they're caught and dealt with. And it is tarnishing the reputation of Battlefield 5 even further than it already has been, and something does need to be done to try and squash this issue once and for all. Getting rid of all cheaters in video games is almost impossible, but it can definitely be dealt with better than it currently is in Battlefield 5. Now, I know the gameplay in the background is showing footage captured on Asian servers, but the cheating problem in Battlefield 5 is by no means exclusive to that region. It is very much a global issue at the moment. It's affecting all regions in quite a negative way. The less a game does to combat cheaters, the more frustrated legitimate players become. At some point, those people, they're just going to stop playing because they're not experiencing fair fights, they're losing to people who have an obvious advantage over them. Having experienced many cheaters during my Battlefield career, I can tell you, it's not fun to be midway through a round of conquest and suddenly a cheater joins the server and kills everybody in sight with some god-tier machine gun, shooting through walls, one-shot killing everybody. It's not fun to experience that. It pretty much spoils the entire round, and once the round ends, it doesn't really feel like a round that you want added to your statistics. You know a cheater's been in there, you didn't have fun with it, why should that count? And then the cheater gets to count that as an official game for themselves as well. They get that on their stats with 150 headshots and a million kills or whatever. That gets counted on their stats if they don't get caught. And in Battlefield 5, often, they can go round to round to round without being banned or caught for their actions, and they are racking up stats, and it is really unfair on all the other players in the server who are playing legitimately. If cheaters know that it's easy to start playing a game with their cheat software active, and they know that they're not likely to be caught quickly and banned for their actions, then those cheaters will stick with that game for longer, and they're going to negatively impact more and more legitimate players the longer they remain active. A tactic many cheaters use is to play a game once using their cheating software, and then not play for a couple of weeks after that. If they then come back after that period of time, and they haven't been banned, then the assumption can be made that the system the game has in place to detect and deal with cheaters isn't particularly robust, and now they can come back and play properly, start using their cheats, and they can feel like they're basically getting away with it. They validate the game to see if it can detect cheating easily or not, and once they realise it can't, then they start playing regularly. If we take a look on the Battlefield 5 website specifically about the efforts being made towards stopping cheaters, we do see some rather stern language being used. We use a combination of in-game and server technology such as Fairfight, along with information from external websites, player reporting, and social channels. Having worked on anti-cheat for a long time, we have the knowledge combined with a refined set of procedures to identify cheating. Now, I'd say at the moment, and pretty much since the launch of Battlefield 5, I'd say that statement is being shown up somewhat. The amount of cheaters present in Battlefield 5 is either growing, or the general player base is shrinking that much that the density of cheaters is growing, making them more obvious to genuine players. That may well be the case in regions that already have less players in the first place, and it could feed into why genuine players in the Asia region are having such a rough time at the moment, especially if the reports of that influx of Chinese cheaters turns out to be true. Now, I have no doubt that DICE does have an anti-cheat system in place for Battlefield 5, and that there is a team of people working through reports, banning people, and working towards improving the systems in place to catch cheaters, but I've got to say, right now, it just doesn't feel like there is. With more and more cases of cheaters being highlighted on communities like Reddit and on social media, it doesn't feel like there's an anti-cheat in place at all, especially when the cheating that's happening is so obvious and it's happening round after round without the cheater being apprehended. Like some of the footage I'm showing you, people shooting through walls and getting multiple kills in a single spray. This isn't normal behaviour, and yet somehow these players are continuing to play round after round without being caught. There is, of course, a reporting system so that you as a player can report someone for hacking, but I see that more as a reactive measure to put in place. What's also needed is something proactive, I think. There may well be something proactive in place that is supposed to protect against cheaters using third-party programs, injecting them into Battlefield 5 to stop players from even launching the game if they're running cheat software, but if that is the case, then clearly that system isn't catching the programs that cheaters are using regularly. And I know that it's a backwards and forwards fight. Those systems change very regularly, DICE's systems change very regularly to try and catch each other out. But you can see again from the gameplay that through the use of third-party programs, these cheaters are able to track player movements through solid objects, they're able to shoot through solid objects, they're able to one-hit kill players with weapons that don't normally one-hit kill people. The list goes on. The proactive protections against cheaters don't appear to be up to standard. They don't feel like they're up to standard for Battlefield 5. And to be honest, it does make Battlefield 5 look like a little bit of a joke. Of course, I know it's easy to rag on Battlefield 5 for pretty much anything at the moment. It's one of the easiest games to have a go at for the amount of issues that it's got. But let's make one thing clear. Every game has a cheating problem. It's impossible to make a game completely invulnerable to cheaters, as they will always find ways around the blocks that are put in place to try and stop them. But games that initially suffer from greater cheating issues, they tend to remain the games with greater cheating issues because the systems in place either aren't good enough to detect and deal with the cheaters, or the cheaters learn that the game is not having its anti-cheat software efforts stepped up over time at a pace that can outstrip the cheats being updated. As I mentioned, it's this constant chase between development teams and cheat developers. And right now for Battlefield 5, I think there's a case to be made that the cheat developers are having more success than they should have. We're talking about a AAA product here. There's a high standard that needs to be met for dealing with cheaters when they surface. If you're in a match and someone is clearly cheating, I'd say either by the end of that round or within that round, the anti-cheat system in place should be able to detect the cheater and deal with that player. Yes, that player might have disrupted your round, but if they're banned soon after, then you know the system is working and you can have confidence that cheaters will be dealt with. But when situations like this one in Asia arise, where nearly every server has a cheater in it, or several, as the case may be, then that just isn't acceptable. And as I've said earlier in the video, this does make Battlefield 5 look like a bit of a joke. That's all I'll say on the cheating issue for the moment. That's me just throwing my hat into the ring and giving my two cents and trying to highlight the clear problems that the Asian community have at the moment with cheating in Battlefield 5. I hope that DICE is working to try and eliminate these cheaters in a more timely way. Battlefield 5 doesn't need this cheating issue on top of everything else that it's already got to deal with at the moment. So here's to hoping that the cheating does start getting combated much more effectively. Thanks very much for watching. My name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.